Welcome to the mathematics class. Today is our fourth lesson in which we will start our new chapter, which is multiplications. Okay, this is the second chapter of your syllabus. So please open page number 68 of your book. Open page number 68 and take out chapter number 5 of your book, which is multiplications. Multiplication. Okay, so if you remember in our previous lectures, in our previous three lectures, we were done with our first chapter, which was addition and subtraction. I hope things are clear with you in the three lectures. Today we'll begin our second chapter, which is multiplication. So I hope that you people know, you just have an idea what multiplication is. There are four basic rules in maths. You do addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. So we are done with addition and subtraction. We learned various methods, how to add and subtract using different methods. So let's have a look at how we do multiplication using various. So first of all, in this slide you can see I have written all the tables. These are really very important. Make sure that you revise all your tables. Table of 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. Make sure you revise all these tables at your home, okay, because these are really very necessary to actually learn this chapter. If you won't remember the tables, then you won't be able to solve the exercises and your assignments. Okay, so make sure you learn all the tables. If you can see, for example, I have a table of 2. 1's are 2, 2's are 4, then 6, 8. So what do we actually do in multiplication? If I have a table of 2, what I do? I plus 2, plus 2, plus 2, plus 2, plus 2, right? 2 plus 2 is 4, plus 2 is 6, plus 2 is 8, then plus 2. Here I have the table of 3, so what do I do? 3 plus 3, plus 3, plus 9 plus 3 is 12, plus 3 is 15, plus 3 is 18. So whenever we are actually forming table of any number, for example the table of 5, I plus 5 plus 5 plus 5 to every single value, okay? So basically multiplication is another form of addition. Instead of adding plus 5 plus 5 plus 5, I simply learned the table of 5 and it would be much easier for me, right? For example, I have 5 multiplied by 3 is 15. Okay, so instead of adding 3 5 times, instead of adding 5 3 times, 5 plus 5 is 10, plus 5 is 15, I simply did 5 multiplied by 3, which is 15. So multiplication is another form of addition, but it's a shortcut method. For example, I have 6 multiplied by 9. So instead of adding 6 9 times, what I do, I simply do 6 multiplied by 9, which is 54. Okay? So multiplication makes things easier for. Now what are multiples? Multiples are basically the numbers which come in a table of any number. For example, I have a multiple. What are multiples of 2? Multiples of 2 are the numbers that come in the table of 2. 2, 4, 2 and the 2, 2 to the 4, 2, 3 the 6, 2, 4 is the 8, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. All these numbers which come in the table of 2 are actually multiples of 2. What are multiples of 4? All the numbers that come in the table of 4 are multiples of 4. 4 1 is a 4, 4 2 is a 8, 4 3 is a 12, 4 4 is a 16. So all these are multiples of 4 because they come in the table of 4. So you need to remember what are multiples. Multiples are the numbers which come in the table of any number. Multiples of 9 would be 9 is a 9, 9 2 is a 18, 9 3 is a 36, like this. Sorry, 9 3s are 27, 9 4s are 36. Okay? Now, what is a product? Product means multiply. The product of 4 and 6 is 24. If I want to find the product of any two numbers, what I would do, I would simply multiply the two numbers and I would gain the product. Okay? So, what is basically a product? The product is final value you by doing multiplication. The product of 8 and 10, what is the product of 8 and 10? 8 multiplied by 10, it's 80. The product of 8 and 10 is 80. So what is the product? A product is the value you get by multiplying any two numbers. Okay? Product of, let's say, what is the product of 7 and 10? What is the product of 7 and 10? 7 multiplied by 10 is 70. So the product of 7 and 10 is 70. So whenever it's written product, that means you need to multiply the two numbers. I can also write, if I say that the product of 8 and 10 is 80, I can also say that 80 is the product of 8 and 10. The product of 8 and 10 is 80, or 80 is the product of 8 and 10. It's the same thing, it's just the sentence is changing. The sentence is basically transforming with the value in the front and the main thing at the back, but still it's the same thing. So let's solve the word problem related to multiplication. First of all, in order to solve the word problems of multiplication, you need to understand how you actually group any two things and the each concept. So for example, you can see there are four balls in this group and there are four balls in this group. Okay? There's a group in which there are four balls, and in this group I again have four balls. So what do we actually do in multiplication? If I ask you what are the total number of balls, if there are two groups and in each group we have four balls, and I ask you what are tell me the total number of balls, or how many balls are there altogether. So what would you do? You start counting 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. Okay, and you'll say that I have 8 balls altogether. Instead of counting like this, as I told you, multiplication is basically a simpler way to do instead of doing addition. Okay, so what I do, I actually use this method. Number of groups multiplied by in each is equals to altogether. If you want to find altogether of anything, the total amount of anything, what you do, you multiply the number of groups with the number in each group. You can see how many groups are there. There are two groups, right? So what I did, 2 multiply by how many are there in each group. Each means, in look at one single group, how many balls are there? 1 2 3 4. In each group I have 4 balls, so I will write 4 here. 2 multiply by 4 is 8. So you can see I got the same answer. Either I start counting 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8, or what I did, I simply multiplied 2 multiplied by 4 and I got 8. So my answer is the same. That means instead of doing addition, I simply multiplied the two numbers and I got my answer. Okay, instead of doing 4 plus 4 and is equals to 8, instead of counting in step of 4, see what I did, 4 plus 4 is 8, right? Instead of counting in steps of 8, what I did, I simply multiplied 4 multiplied by 2, which is 8. So instead of adding numbers and making things more complicated, you simply do the addition. You simply do the multiplication. You multiply the number of groups with the thing in each group, and you get the altogether thing, or you get the total amount of anything. Okay. So there are 8 balls altogether. Remember, 2 multiplied by 4 or 4 multiplied by 2, both are same thing. If you write 2 multiplied by 4, it's the same as 4 multiplied by 2. There is no difference in that. Okay, there is no difference between them. It's up to you which sequence you want. Now let's say I have 3 groups. If I ask you tell me the total number, or tell me how many stars are there altogether, or tell me the total number of stars. So what would you do? 1 2 3 4. 4 plus 4 plus 4. 4 plus 4 is plus 4 is 12. So you will say that I have 12 stars altogether. But if I want you to do some multiplication and make things easier with you, how would you do that? As I told you before, number of groups multiplied by in each group would give you altogether. So how many groups are there? 1, 2 and 3. There are 3 groups. And how many in each group? 1, 2, 3, 4. There are 4 stars in each group. If I simply multiply 3 multiplied by 4, I'll get 12. So there are 12 stars altogether. So instead of doing addition, 4 plus 4, instead of counting in step of 4, counting in step of 4 means 4 plus 4 plus 4, instead of doing this, what I did, I simply multiplied 4 multiplied by 3 and I got my answer, which is 12. Okay? Remember, if my answer is 12, so the product of 3 and 4 is 12. The product of 3 and 4 is 12, or you can also say 12 is the product of 3 and 4. Okay? So it's time to solve a book exercise. Please open page number 72 and 73 of your book. Okay, and make sure you solve this book exercise. Take out page number 72 and 73. Make sure that you revise all your tables back at home, okay? Before starting this exercise, make sure you learn all your tables. Otherwise, you won't be able to complete this exercise properly, or you will make a lot of mistakes. So make sure that you learn all your tables and then you attempt this exercise. And remember, whenever you have been asked product, that means you need to multiply the two numbers. Counting in step means counting, for example, I am counting in step of 5 means 5 plus 5 plus 5. I am counting in step of 6 means 6 plus 6 plus 6. Like this. Instead of doing a complicated addition, I simply multiply number of groups multiplied by in each group is equal to all together. You need to remember these things, okay? Learn your table and then solve this exercise. If you have any query, any question, make sure you watch the lecture again and solve your query before attempting this exercise. Make sure you complete all your assignments. We'll continue with our with the next section in the next lecture. Okay? So till then, Allah Hafiz.